Hello friends, myself Professor Prashant Mahajan, working as an assistant professor at AISSMS Institute of Information Technology. Today we are going to see external treatment, that is ion exchange, which is also called as deionization method, and desalination of brackish water. So in that we are going to see electrodialysis and reverse osmosis process. So first, ion exchange. So in the zeolite process, there is an exchange of only cations. In this method, there is the exchange of cations as well as anions. So you can see the diagram. This is a cation exchanger resin or bead. This is anion exchanger resin or bead. This is water coming from this side. Here only cations present in the water will get exchanged, and then water goes to the anion exchanger bead where cations get exchanged. So here only cations will exchange, here only anions will exchange, then that will go to the inductivity meter and that will be go to the degasifier. If any gases are present, that gases get removed. After certain time, that bed get exhausted, that is cation exchanger bed get exhausted as well as anion exchanger bed get exhausted. So that can be removed, regenerated by dilute HCl and dilute NaOH. So process, it can remove both cations as well as anions. Then anion exchange resins are insolubles, cross-linked, long-chain organic polymer with microporous structure and functional group attached to the chain are responsible for ion exchanging properties. Means it is having functional group like SO3H or carboxylate. Or this one, that is Nr3 plus NH2 and Me3OH or OH. So in short, it can be written as RH2, or it is written here RH2. If it is cation exchanger resin, it can be written as RH2, and if it is anion exchanger resin, it can be written as ROH twice. So this hydrogen is loosely bound to this sulfonic group that can be exchanged with the calcium and magnesium. Similarly, this hydroxide is loosely bound to this ammonium salt group that can be exchanged with the chlorides or sulfates or nitrates present in the water. So you can see the reaction. This is cation exchanger resin, this calcium plus 2, it is from the water. So this H plus or H2 is get exchanged with this R, this calcium, that will become RCA plus 2H plus. Similarly, magnesium is converted to RMG. So cation get exchange in the first compartment. Similarly, anion get exchanged with second compartment. So this OH, it is replaced by this Cl2, and similarly this OH is replaced by SO4 2 minus, so that will become R-SO4. So precaution, what precaution you have to take, that is hard water has calcium and magnesium ions. If the anions unit is placed ahead of the cation unit, the exchange of chlorides, bicarbonates, etc. will generate corresponding hydroxide. Since the anion resin is in hydroxide form, this will result in calcium and magnesium hydroxide to precipitate in anion resin unit and shock the bed. Means what? If we do this procedure first, what happens? There is a formation of hydroxide and that will react with magnesium, and then it will form magnesium hydroxide precipitate that will chalk up this bed, and there will be no cation exchanger procedure. Then regeneration, that means after some time that bed get exhausted. Means what? This cation exchanger bed get exhausted as well as this anion bed get exhausted. So that can be regenerated by dilute HCl and dilute NaOH. So magnesium R on reaction with HCl will produce H2R and magnesium chloride. Similarly, calcium R will produce H2R and calcium chloride. RCl2 on reaction with NaOH will give R-OH twice and twice NaCl. Similarly, R-sulfate will give you R dash OH and sodium sulfate. Means you can see here, this is for softening. This diagram, it is for softening process, and this is for regeneration, dilute HCl and washing, dilute NaOH and washing. So this is for regeneration. And next is advantages. So water with 0 to 2 ppm hardness, which is very low, can be obtained from this method. Second, process can be used for highly acidic or alkaline process. So these are the two advantages. Next is limitation. So high initial investment, that is equipment use, is costly. Next is chemical use are expensive. Then cannot be used for turbid solution. So that are the limitation of ion exchange process. The last part of the unit is desalination of brackish water. So what is brackish water? It is the water which contains high concentration of salts, that is 35 gram per liter. For example, sea water or deep borewell water. So it is containing large amount of sodium chloride. That is, desalination means what? Removing of common salts, mostly NaCl present in the water. That procedure is called as desalination. So there are two methods. So one is membrane process. So we are going to deal only with membrane process. In that, we are going to see electrodialysis and reverse osmosis. So already you have seen reverse osmosis in the 12th. So we are going to see both of them. So electrodialysis means what? So electro itself indicates that is there is cathode, there is anode, and there is electrolyte. That means electrodialysis, or there is a electric current. So first, electrodialysis, the process of removing ionic pollutants such as salts and dyes from water by using membranes and electric field is known as electrodialysis. So construction and working. An electrodialysis unit consists of a large amount of or large number of paired sets of plastic membranes. These membranes are ion selective. Means what? If cation selective electrode is there, means it is made up of or it is having functional group SO3 2 minus or COO minus. If anion selective electrode is there, it is having group NR3 plus or C5H5N+R. Means it will attract Na plus from the NaCl, it will attract Cl minus from NaCl. So what is going to happen? You can see, when an electric field is applied perpendicular to the direction of flow of water, anion move towards positively charged electrode through anion selective membrane. Similarly, cation move towards negatively charged electrode through cation selective membrane. Alternate compartments of pure water. So alternate compartment obtain pure water. So you can see the diagram, as I said. So these are the electrode, C for cation, which is attached to the negative terminal. So C, C and C, that is minus charge, and A, A and A, that is plus charge. So we are going to apply electric field perpendicular to the direction of flow of water. So if we put sea water from here, cation exchange resin or cation exchanger will attract this plus charge from the compound. If NaCl is there, that will attract Na plus, and anode will attract Cl minus. Similarly, from here Na plus will come, here Cl minus, here Na plus, here Cl minus. That means Cl minus from here and Na plus from here, that will give you NaCl. Similarly, here NaCl. So here NaCl is removed, Na is removed, Cl is removed. So you will get pure water from here pure water, and from here pure water. That means alternate chamber is containing pure water. Similarly, alternate chamber will give you salt rich water. So if it is NaCl, you will get NaCl, and you can recover NaCl from this salt rich water. Then application, removal of ionic pollutant from treated industrial waste. That means you can remove ionic pollutant only. And second, removal of salt from sea water to get pure water. So that is nothing but NaCl. Third, removal of limited quantity of salt from sea water to get drinking water. And last, salt rich water can be used to recover salt. That is application. And last, limitation, it does not remove dissolved organic matter. Second, it does not remove colloidal impurities. And last, membrane replacement required frequently. That will increase the cost of the process. And last, that is reverse osmosis. So already we know osmosis, that is osmosis means it is the natural phenomenon, that is the example is dilution, that is natural phenomenon. So osmosis is where the solvent flows from lower concentration to higher concentration through semi-permeable membrane. That is osmosis. You can see where the solvent flows from lower concentration to higher concentration solution through semi-permeable membrane. In reverse osmosis, the solvent flow is reverse. That is flow from higher concentration to lower concentration through semi-permeable membrane. So that is not going to happen naturally. For that, we have to apply external pressure slightly higher than osmotic pressure to the higher concentration solution, is known as reverse osmosis. In the reverse osmosis, we apply external pressure on the higher concentration side slightly higher than osmotic pressure. So that is external pressure is greater than osmotic pressure. So in reverse osmosis, we are separating water from contaminants rather than contaminants from water. That means in case of this one, we are separating contaminants from water. That means there is a chances of contaminants in the water. But here there is no chances because we are separating only water. So you can see the diagram. So this is the process of osmosis. That is flow from lower to higher concentration. That is given here, C2 is greater than C1. So C2 concentration is higher and C1 is lower. In the case of reverse osmosis cell, this is sea water which is having higher concentration. This is semi-permeable membrane and this is pure water. So we are going to apply external pressure slightly greater than osmotic pressure. So what happens? This semi-permeable membrane only permits small water molecules and it will prevent or retard the ionic salts or salts present in the seawater. So method, seawater is polluted by organic ionic pollutants is filled in the reverse osmosis cell. So this is there. A pressure of 200 psi is applied on it to force the solvent to pass through semi-permeable membrane. So semi-permeable membrane has porosity that it allows only small molecules of water solvent to pass through and higher size molecules are prohibited from passing. That means it will permit only small size water molecule and it will prohibited higher size molecule. And last, membrane consists of a polymeric material film made up of proper porosity from material like acrylics, polyamides and aramids. That means this is made up of acrylics, polyamides and aramids. So this is the method of reverse osmosis. The next is advantages. So all ionic, colloidal, non-ionic and organic impurities are removed. Simple to operate, low cost, pure water for high pressure boiler can be obtained. And last, if the semi-permeable membrane is specially prepared such that it allows limited quantity of salt to pass through it along with water, then RO technique is used to obtain drinking mineral water. So these are the advantages. All ionic impurities, colloidal impurities, non-ionic impurities can remove. Simple to operate, low cost process, and it can give high pressure boilerplate water. And last, if the semi-permeable membrane is specially prepared such that it allows limited quantity of salts to pass through it along with water, then RO technique is used to obtain drinking mineral water. So we are using RO technique at our home for preparation or softening of water. And last, efficiency of the process depends upon the physical, chemical and mechanical strength of the semi-permeable membrane. So that's it about electrodialysis and reverse osmosis process. Thank you.